Hallelujah. I'm so grateful to God for counting on you and I worthy to be among those that will see another day again in the year 2020. And we give him all the glory. Today on this platform of Second Ambassadors, we'll be considering another important topic. And our topic for today is abortion. Don't do it. Abortion, don't do it. And our text is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 30. Verse 21. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21. But before we proceed, I would like us to pray. Our Father, our God, we want to give you praise for counting us worthy to be among those that will see this day in year 2020. We thank you for the privilege of being alive. We appreciate your name for being there for us. Lord, we say be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank you for all that we have done in the past weeks and for counting us again worthy to be able to even learn out of it again today. Lord, we say be glorified in Jesus' name. We pray, oh God, that as we go on, Lord, you will teach us yourself in Jesus' name. We pray that you will touch my tongue, and Lord, you cause your words alone that you want us to be heard in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray you will take control. At the end, let all of us be mightily blessed. Thank you because you have answered. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And so, like I told us earlier, our topic for today is abortion. Don't do it. And our text is from the book of Isaiah 30, verse 31. And like many of us will agree with me, that for many years, abortion has been a very controversial topic. Some people are in support of the idea of abortion, and why some people are actually against it. And there are medical reasons to support abortion in some instances. But there's something that you and I, we, as Christians, we need to understand, that God, our Father in heaven, wants the best for his children. He wants his best for us. At every given time, he's always there to make us to understand, you know, his purpose. He wants us to be fruitful. He wants us to multiply. And so that means that when it comes to abortion, we need to be very, very careful to know his mind on it. And I pray will give us understanding in the name of Jesus. And there's another thing I also want us to understand when it comes to abortion, and that's the fact that whichever angle that we may want to look at it, there is always a sense of loss. You know, if we have, you know, I don't know if you have gotten something before, and eventually that thing is no longer there. You know, as a man, you somehow, you know, you will feel it. You'll be bothered by that thing that we have lost. So whichever way we want to just look at this particular topic, I want us to understand that, you know, there is always a sense of loss. But for today, by the grace of God, we are not considering abortion in the medical line. We'll be considering abortion as it relates to us as sex ambassadors. So for this discussion, we refer abortion to be a deliberate midway termination of a God-given dream. Let me repeat that. I said that for our discussion, we refer abortion to a deliberate midway termination of a God-given dream. That means that if at any time in our lives we have aborted, if at any time in our life we have terminated God's dream, that means we have committed abortion. And so we all need to understand that the Almighty God that created you and I, that have kept us to today, he has his own plan for our lives. And there are things that God wants us to achieve. You know, we all see pregnant women, and we see the way, you know, they will carry their baby from the first month, second month, third month, and before we know it, the belly will start to, you know, become bigger. And that means that God, in his own infinite mercies, he has given us the grace, everything that we need, you know, as his children, to be able to nurse our dream. He wants us to, you know, to take care of them, to grow, you know, from glory to glory. That is his mind for us. It's however sad that so many of us, you know, we have not taken time to even understand his purpose. We are not even taking time to know what God has kept in us. And that's why in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21, he said, "We shall hear the voice behind us, that the voice will tell us that this is the way, walk in it." So like I told us earlier, that many of us, we have about aborted God's plan. You may want to ask me how, and but then if you look at how you have made your marital choice, if you look at the way you have, you know, where you are settling down at the moment, if you look at the job you are doing, if you look at the career you are into, can you confidently say that God has led you into such? You know, if God has not led you, that means in a way you've not been able to hearken to that God's command that says this is the way, walk in it. You know, some of us might want to say that, well, I'm not hearing God. But then I want us to understand that God, you know, every woman that will say carrying pregnancy today, you know, why some years ago, you will not even know that they can carry the pregnancy or they can carry the child. They are just like every normal girl, every normal lady. But then a time comes for them to be fruitful, and then they became fruitful. That means for you and I, God himself knows that, you know, we can actually, we have a dream and we have a purpose to fulfill. So it's not for God to probably show us in the dream or to appear to us or send an angel to us. It's for us to search, you know, for that purpose, for us to seek that purpose, for us to, you know, get that dream. And then when God has given us the dream, then we can now begin to nurse it and to see it come into fruition. And that means that as Christians, God wants us to, you know, reassess our lives, reassess our marriage, reassess the work we do, reassess our career, and see if there are ways that we have missed it, and then we can always come back to him. And a very good example for us to understand this topic is that of our brother Joseph. Brother Joseph, from his teenage year, you know, he had dreams. And he, you know, at that time he was not wise enough. He shared the dreams with his father. He shared the dream with his brothers. But then these particular brothers, you know, they had a plan. They had a plan against him to abort that particular dream. But then, you know, God being a faithful father, God being a faithful God, he also gave Brother Joseph the strength, you know, to be able to withstand the opposition. You know, he found himself in a foreign land. You know, he passed through a lot of hurdles, but God was with him. And of course, his own godly character also helped him to be able to carry the child to the time of delivery. And to the glory of God, he was able to, you know, carry that baby to the appointed time when he eventually became a ruler in a foreign land. In the land of Egypt, King Pharaoh pronounced him a ruler. King Pharaoh made him, you know, the second in command in a foreign land. Why? Because he was able, you know, to pass through the pain. He was able to carry the child. He was able to nurture that dream until it became fulfilled. Brother Jonah, in the book of Jonah, in contrast, you know, he willingly decided to abort God's plan for his life. When God told him to go to Nineveh, he chose to God to do otherwise. He chose to go to Tarshish. And then he fled to Tarshish. If we read that book of Jonah chapter 1, he fled to Tarshish. He did not even stop there. Bible said that he went down to Joppa. That means God told him to go to Nineveh, but on his own, he went to Tarshish. He fled to Tarshish. He did not stop there. He also went down to Joppa. Many of us, we are in that shoe. You know, God will tell us who to marry. God will tell us the job to do. God will tell us, you know, where he wants us to settle. But because of our own, you know, personal reasons, or maybe because of our ego, we want to do otherwise. In fact, we will not just do otherwise. We also go the extra mile in the wrong direction. And I pray that today God will deliver us in Jesus' name. So that means that if, you know, we decide to do contrary to God's plan, we have actually aborted his plan, because the God that created us, he has a plan, he has a purpose why he has created us. So, but then there's one important thing I want us to understand about God again this afternoon, and that is the place of his mercies. You know, when Jonah realized his mistake, you know, he went back to God, and God, you know, restored him. So that means that no matter how, you know, how far you might have gone, you know, in the wrong direction, God can still restore you. If you can actually, you know, go back to him genuinely, you know, repent of your sin, he can actually help you. He can make that marriage work. He can make that career to work again. He can make that place you are settled in currently, you know, to be, for you to begin to thrive again. So that means the Almighty God in his infinite mercies can actually restore us. But there's one thing you and I, we need to do. We need to go back to him. And of course, if you have not made any plan to abort, you have not aborted any dream, but I want to encourage you to continue to nurse it And of course, as you know, God himself will give you the strength to be able to give birth to that child or that dream at its appointed time in Jesus' name. At the same time, I want us to remember the book, the story of our sister Elizabeth in the book of Luke chapter 1. The Bible says that when he saw Mary, he said the baby in him lived again. You know, the Bible says that the baby in her lived in joy. So that means that the baby in us can actually leap again if we can actually understand the place of the Holy Spirit. So I want to encourage us this afternoon as we go into this week and the rest of the year to carry that baby, to nurse that pregnancy, and to see that that dream becomes fulfilled. Please don't do abortion, and God will help us all in Jesus' name. And so today our prayer point will be, Father, please cause my dry bones to live again. And we can say that in the book of Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1 to 10. And Father in heaven, we pray in the name of Jesus that every dry bone in our lives, we pray that Lord God, you will cause them to live again in Jesus' name. Everywhere we have missed it, we pray that by your mercies you will restore us, that all glory, that all praise will be unto your name. Thank you, everlasting Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. We want to appreciate God for giving us this opportunity again to encourage ourselves in his vineyard. And it's our prayer that if your time is coming, he will give us the grace to meet again next week. And so, till then, please don't forget, abortion, don't do it. God bless you, and have a wonderful week. Bye.